All right, let's talk servers. Servers are the entire reason that networks exist, sort of. I'm lying. But servers are really important for making things work. And you're going to be working with servers a lot anytime you're doing something with networks. Most likely, you're talking about a client and a server and some sort of environment like that. Now, there are other ways to interact with networking, such as peer-to-peer, but for the most part, you're talking about client-server interactions. So what is a server in that relationship? And for that matter, what's a client? What does a client even mean when we talk about clients and servers and all this stuff? Well, let's figure that out. And what types of servers do you interact with regularly? Because I guarantee it's a lot of them, some of them more than others, but you interact with a lot of servers in your day-to-day networked life. So when you first think of a server, most likely this is what comes to mind. Maybe some sort of dark, long hallways full of networking equipment. Maybe somebody sitting there with a laptop. Maybe somebody sitting there with some sort of rolling cart of some kind. And maybe you have no idea what we're even talking about when we talk about servers. And that's okay too. But in any case, this is servers. You've got, in this case, in some sort of data center environment, you've got a stack of a whole bunch of servers and cables running everywhere to make this stuff work. Here's another example. This is inside any one of those racks that we saw here. Inside one of these racks, you'll have a whole bunch of servers stacked on top of each other with networks, cables running to them and fiber optic cables running to them to make them work. Well, that's all definitely true. And here's another picture of this. And that is all. This is servers. This is what servers look like in a data center environment, in, say, an AWS data center, or even an individual company might have a data center and have a room full of equipment like this. But, it's important to remember that yes, those are servers. Yes, racks and rows of racks of equipment and cables running everywhere. Those are servers. You can be referring to that dedicated hardware that runs networking services. But you can also be referring to software. Software running on those computers. And in fact, most often the important part is the software that's running, and the hardware is just there to make that software work. So you've got hardware, you've got software, and sometimes when we're talking about servers, what we're really talking about is both of them. So when we say the word server, we might be referring to hardware, we might be referring to software, we might be referring to the hardware that's running the software, all of it together. It really depends on the context, so important to keep that in mind. So hardware servers, what is a hardware server? It's dedicated hardware to run those software servers. So in those racks that we saw, we had each of those little units that was, I don't know, this wide on the screen, about that tall on the screen, was a server. And it had a processor, and it had memory, and it had storage, and it had potentially graphics capabilities, and it had networking capabilities. And all of those things were the hardware that run the software servers. Typically with that kind of equipment, you don't have a dedicated screen, unlike a desktop computer that typically has a screen and a mouse and a keyboard attached to it. Network servers are just sitting there, and their only input and output is through the network. Now you can plug a monitor into it, you can plug a keyboard and mouse into it if you want to, but typically most of the time they're sitting there without any sort of connection once they're initially set up. And even initially, they might be set up over the network without ever connecting a screen or mouse of any kind. But in the end, it's really just a computer. That fancy form factor and being able to put it on a rack and things like that, that's all fantastic, and that's to make it work in a data center and to make it fit nicely in a data center. But really, it's just a computer, just like your desktop. It has the same equipment, the same types of equipment at least, if not the exact same equipment, as your computer that's sitting on your desk or your laptop that's sitting on your desk. Because that's what computers are, and that's how all this stuff works. So your computer then can act as a hardware server to run a software server. Because again, the hardware servers that we're talking about are really just a way to run software servers. And this is an application that's running on the computer that performs the function of a server. Now, what does a server do? They are the real workhorses. Like I said, the software servers are what's sitting there doing the actual work. They can run on any computer, including those hardware dedicated servers. And really, they do stuff with stuff. Their job is to sit, listen for some sort of request or command, and then do something in response and potentially send something back in response to that. So what are these functions that we're seeing? Like I said, first of all, you're going to listen. It's going to take an address of some kind, like an IP address, and a port of some kind, like a transport layer TCP port. Put those together, call it a socket, and say, hey, I'm listening. If anybody sends to this computer something on this socket, send it to me, and I will do something with it. And so the server's sitting there, and it's listening. And that's primarily what makes it a server, is that it is open and sitting there awaiting a request. And when that request comes, it's going to do something with that request. So it gets a request and it does whatever it is that is requested. So in the case of, for example, a web server, what is received is a request to send a file. And that file is an HTML file typically, but it receives a request for the file. It says, okay, I found the file. It sends the response. There's the file, here's the file that you asked for, and we're done. And that is the server interaction. So what kinds of servers might you see? What kinds of servers are you interacting with? Well, for one, there's web servers. Like I said, so web servers serve up any of the websites that you visit on the internet. So their job is to deliver files that are typically HTML files or something along those lines and pass those along to the users or to the clients that are requesting those files. So if you visit google.com or schetzler.net or any website on the internet, you're interacting with a web server like this whose job it is to respond and provide those files. Nginx and Apache are the two probably biggest. IIS is Microsoft's web server. That's another one. It's very similar along the same lines as Nginx and Apache. So you also have mail servers. Mail servers' job is to deliver the mail, to receive mail, to respond to requests to send mail, to respond to requests to get mail. And mail servers, the most common mail servers are probably Exchange and Postfix. Exchange if you're Windows-based, Postfix if you're Linux-based. But really, again, they do more or less the same thing. They send and receive email. And then you've also got application servers. And you might be familiar with application servers like this one right here. Python manage.py run server. If you have run a Django application in the past, this is what you've done. And that is an application server. And the application server's job is to receive a request, pass it off to some code to do some stuff, and return a response, either a view or something along those lines, right? You've done that before. GUnicorn is a production version of that, and there are similar application servers for pretty much every language that you might ever have to work with that works on the web. So the idea of the application server is that unlike like a web server that takes requests and returns a static file, an application server is doing some fancy stuff with the request before it returns, again, a static file. It returns an index or an HTML file, just like these ones. It just has to do a lot more work to get there. So there's a lot of other types of servers too. Web servers, email servers, application servers are great. You work with those and you interact with those all the time, but there's a lot of others. There's database servers is a great example. Database servers like PostgreSQL or MySQL or Oracle or SQL Server, all of these are servers that run on a hardware server, again, and they respond to requests for data and they get responses. So in addition to database servers, we've got file servers, and a file server is kind of like a web server. A web server is kind of a specialized file server that's designed to serve HTML files and CSS and respond to requests very quickly. A file server is for serving files, providing users with the files that they request, or storing or updating or whatever those files. Fantastic stuff. There are also media servers like Plex. There's lots of others ways to serve media. Netflix, I'm sure, has bazillions of specialized media servers around the world to do its job of streaming those data. YouTube, similar. Lots of servers specialized for the purpose of streaming that media. There are print servers. Print servers do printing. Pretty simple. And game servers. If you play video games, every game has its own special interaction and ways of communicating. And if you play networked video games, you've probably heard people complain about netcode and all that stuff. And really all it is game servers have a way of receiving information from all the people who are playing the game, updating all the other people who are playing the game about where players are and how things work and who shot who and all that stuff. And all that stuff is done in the game server. And all these are probably the most common types of servers. It's probably about all the servers you're going to need to know. But there's others. Keep an eye out as you learn more about what goes on a network. Keep an eye out for different kinds of servers and what role those servers might fill in addition to what we've talked about here. So what is a client? What is a client? What does it do for you? What are clients that you interact with? A client's job is to talk to a server. It's that simple. A client's job is to send information to a server or request information from a server that the server can respond to. That's about it. That is what clients do. And you interact with a lot of different clients all the time. Anytime you connect your computer to the internet, you're interacting with some kind of clients. For example, Slack, Chrome, Firefox, Safari, whatever browser you use. Apple Mail, if you use that for your email, that's a client for a mail server. Twitter is a client, whether it's your app on your phone or the web application. In either case, it's talking to Twitter servers to do some stuff. It's talking to Twitter's application servers to show you a list of tweets. Zoom has its own servers. Over here we've got Instagram, Dropbox. Each of these has clients. Every application that you run on your computer that does something on the network is a client. It's talking to a server. Unless it's specifically one of those peer-to-peer, like I said, applications where you're sending information to other peers, other clients, instead of to servers. But for the most part, you've got this client-server architecture where clients, like your applications on your computer, are sending data to and receiving data from servers somewhere in the world. So before we go, check yourself. I want you to first look through the applications on your phone and or your computer, both preferably, and figure out how many of them are network clients. How many applications that you use are doing something on the network, and what kinds of servers do you think they're talking to? Is it an application server? Is it a database server? Is it a web server? Is it a print server? I don't know. You've got a lot of applications on your computer, so what are they doing? What are they talking to? And I want you to think about this. It's kind of a trick question. If you are running a Python server, like Python manage.py run server on your computer, and you connect to it through your web browser, is your computer the client or is your computer the server? Think about that for a minute, and I'll give you the answer in about 20 seconds. If you pause the video for 20 seconds. The answer is, it's both. Your computer is not really either of them. The application that's running the server is the server, and your web browser is the client. And so you are playing both roles at the same time. And that is at least the basics of how servers work.